I've been to Timbuktu during the crisis. The living condition for the population was hard. There was no administration. There was no bank. The only structure that was open, the hospital. When we got there, we introduced ourselves to the authority. Right away, he told us, well, you are welcome. Go into the hospital and take the hospital. But the hospital was not really functioning. Majority of the medical staff fled. Those we met were volunteers. But it was not easy to find people to go into Timbuktu for fear that they would be killed. And gradually we took over the entire hospital. I think we had a good collaboration with the people. We told them what we want to do, what we believe in. I told them, you have your law. I will respect your law, but you respect my principles. My principles are, you don't mix religion into what I do. My specialty is to treat, and I treat anybody. Even you, you come, I will treat you. They respected us for that. They saw that we were transparent, and whatever we wanted to do, we did it openly, so we accepted. And we had regular meeting with the authority there. At one point, I called the leader and said that if you enter the premises of the hospital with arms, you're going to frighten the patient. There are many sick people outside there. They won't come because they see you with arms. So you don't. So they promised me, and when they enter, they will leave their arm at the door. The region is very big. It's desert, very hot at times, difficult terrain, and you have to work very hard. We went thinking that we will receive more ward wounded patient. It was in January we received wounded, around 30. We have more deliveries, more cesarean operation, treating more malaria, chronic diseases not related to war. It became chronic because they had nowhere to go. In the face of difficulty, you cannot see a patient coming and say, look, we are only here for emergency, so you leave. We said, no, we cannot be in the hospital and these people are suffering, so we must help them.
Thank you.